very, very few outsiders Garmin had ever seen working. A short, wrinkled dirt with a tempered match.
Are you embarking or what?
Garmin continued wiping his helmet. I'm waiting for my mates.
You shift your shiny silver backside now!
The old man said irritably.
I got a schedule!
Garmin carefully brought up his gun belt just under the lip to his chin and held it. He didn't need to eject the Bible. He didn't need to say a word. He figured.
Well, whenever you're ready, sir.
The mirrors, stepping back to chibi clone troopers instead. It wasn't a great idea to have said a command, especially not after coming down from the adrenaline of combat. But there was still no sign of the rest of the squad. Garmin knew that there was no point waiting. They hadn't called in. Maybe they had conflict. Maybe they had made it onto another gunship. It was the first time in his artificially short life that Garmin hadn't been able to reach out and touch the men that he was raised with. He waited half a standard hour on end until the gunships became less frequent and the lines of troopers became shorter. Eventually, there was nobody standing in the building for him. The bureau slowly and half a dozen phone troopers. It was the last lift of the day.
You better come now, sir,
the loadmaster said.
There's nobody unaccounted for. Nobody alive.
Garmin looked around the horizon one last time, still feeling as if he was turning his back on someone reaching out to him.
I'm coming, he said, and brought up the rear lane.
As the gunship lifted, he watched the swirling dust, dwindling rock formations, and scattered shrinking patches of scrub until geonosis became a blur of doorway. He could still search for the platform. It wasn't over yet. The gunship slipped into the platform of a giant dock. Garmin looked down into the cabin onto a sea of white armor and whirling wood. The first thing that struck him when the gunship killed its thrusters and locked down its pad was how quiet everyone seemed. In the crowded bay full of troops, the air stank of sweat and stale fear and the throat-rasping smell of discharged blaster rounds. But it was so silent that Garmin hadn't seen the evidence of exhaustion or injured damage. He had believed that nothing significant deck vibrated with the soles of his boots. He was still staring downward, studying the random patterns of Geonosian dust that clung to him, when an identical pair came into view. Namba, said a voice that was also his. The commander slipped into the talent center. Anything else would have mattered, because the sensors and the enhanced guitar and armor reported his status silently. No significant. The triage team from Geonosis had waited past, concentrating on the injury, ignoring both those too badly hurt to help and those who could help themselves.
Are you listening to me? Come on, talk to me, son.
All of us.
Sir, I'll see 1136. I'm not sure.
He paused. Nobody else was going to call him. This squad didn't even know.
They were all dead. Jay, then Tower, he just knew. Sir, any news on C-1133?
No, said the commander, who had obviously heard a similar question every time he stopped to check. He gestured with a small bar in his hand.
If they're not in case back or listed on this sweep, they didn't make it.
It was a stupid question to ask. Garmin should have known that. Clone troopers, and especially Republic commanders, just got on with the job. That was their sole purpose, and they were lucky their training sergeant had told them, outside of the ordinary world, every being from every species in the galaxy fretted about their purpose. Searching for meaning, a clone, a meat, clones, men. They had been perfecting for their role, doubt, and being one of them. Garmin had never known what doubt was until now. No amount of training prepared him for this. He found a space against the bulkhead and sat down. A clone trooper settled down next to him, squeezing into the gap and briefly crossing his shoulder blade with his hips. They glanced at each other. Garmin rarely had any contact with human clones. Commando was trained apart from everyone, including ARC troopers. The exactly who he would be.
Nice DC.
Troopers said the police. He was looking at the DC 17. Troopers were issued the heavy, low spec for the DC 15.
Ion pulse, RPG anti armor, and sniper?
Yeah. Every item of his gear was manufactured to a higher spec. A trooper's gun was less valuable. Darman had absolute confidence that he was one of the best special ops soldiers ever.